Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the Geektech Industries X-Wing tabletop coming from Kippers Melee. Here we are with day number two. We have our single round eliminations. We got three rounds coming. This is the first quarterfinals. On table one, we have Calen against Wes. Now, Calen went absolutely undefeated yesterday with his list of Redline, Death Rain, and Whisper. He sure knows how to fly those ships. And Wes, on the other side of the board, is flying some Rebels. He's got Dutch Vander, Thane Kyrell, Wedge Antilles, and AP5. Gotta love that Wedge. Such an amazing X-Wing pilot these days. Yeah. That was everybody. That was everyone. Slow rolling with those Punishers. No surprise there. We had a really great day yesterday with all of our matches. Elimination matches went fantastic. Or Swiss matches went fantastic, my bad. We also have our Hangar Bay matches going on, which unfortunately we don't have on camera right now. No forward one with Redline. And there's Stickus returning to the computer.
So just want to show one of these will be for the Hangar Bay. These guys, top three are going to get flasks. Top winners are number one gets their pick of either the range rules or templates, and the number two gets the other.
And what's the other one of those for?
Draw. It's going for the draw.
Just Stickus coming around talking about the prizing that we have available for our tournament winners here today. Both our Hangar Bay winners and our official standard play, or extended play as it is nowadays.
Awesome, thanks, bro. You the man, cool guy.
We're on.
Did you move your gear up?
Yeah, my gear's all moved up.
Awesome.
So Stickus is now joining us back here at the microphone. Why don't you say something?
What's up, everybody? How you doing?
Yeah, there we go.
So we're underway here at Kippers Melee, second day.
I told them all this already.
I know. I like repeating yourself, though. So, of course, we've got Calen on the left side, Wes on the right. Have you already gone over their list?
I sure have.
Awesome.
Not
I should have known. This is, you're not this
you,
in your
you,
first
you
rodeo.
You chose to get up and walk away at the start time.
The
what were you?
Time.
Start time. You could have waited until after launching.
Oh, whatever. God, you're so bitter.
Reliably.
What? An easy viewing of your player list.
Oh, yeah.
Need to make ID or cards to put in the draw.
That's there.
Ladder. Bloop. Okay.
Sure I can look around.
Calen, Scott, Mike.
I unfortunately have to put last
name. Need last
name.
Yeah, exactly.
Calen. Calen, Scott.
Yeah.
What's Scott's last name?
Roebuck. Like Sears. Mike, the Messiah.
Maybe we don't need all of those going over here.
How do you spell his last name?
M-A-S-S.
Just gonna mute the microphone for a quick moment. Some more slow roll coming from those Punishers, or at least that Punisher. Taking his time. Probably going to set himself up for some beautiful rock destruction positioning. Oh, that's a remarkably silent moment there. But we're back.
S-T-E-I-C-H-E.
End of round two.
Jesse's gone, and then you're the man there. Yo, man. He has been, like, top shelf all week.
He actually really has been. He's been very well behaved.
He
comes over and politely asks.
He is welcome to every one of my events ever now.
We have had some good conversations.
Some deep contemplation from the Rebellion side. All right, microphone's back full time. Sorry about that, folks. We had some sensitive information being spoken about on this end. There goes that seismic charge. Okay, I'm back again.
A little bit of positioning coming from Death Rain there.
Oh, yeah. Standard decloak out. I really appreciate how Calen will use his target locks to measure to see how far he's got to move, say, how far is that rock away, how far is my opponent, and then end up target locking either one of his friendlies or the rock, because it doesn't
legal.
Matter.
Yeah.
It feels to me like old style target lock, where you're like, oh, I'm going to attempt a target lock. Okay, now I know that you are range 6 away. Okay.
Yeah.
A little bit of finesse and finagling there from Wes.
Just squeezes AP5 past.
Yeah, it was
just
nice.
That
was nice to see.
That was a good maneuver.
I think next year I need to get some more lights.
Yeah.
As much as I've got, like,
even
way
even
better
just
than
like
webcam
a
was.
Table lamp or something.
Yeah, just to add extra light to
well,
this.
Can you turn up the...
No, I've already got f-stop cranked to the lowest. The other thing is, when you decrease the f-stop, you're decreasing your depth of field for focus as well. And so, for example, it would focus here, but everything in the back would be out of focus. Weird technical things that I've been learning by getting a better camera. As well?
I did.
Did you eat one of your hash browns already?
Yes.
Okay, then that is my hash browns.
Yes, it is.
I'm just nomming a little breakfast. Gotta keep myself fueled here to keep this day going. Calen really pushing Deathfire up there.
Coming around for that hard flank.
Gotcha.
Medium base barrel rolling is kind of a little different.
It looks obvious, it's just the new way your barrel's burning, you don't actually measure. But since this is half the length of that, it equals up, and this is half the length of the larger base. It looks weird.
Yeah.
The first data is like, what? Oh, okay, yeah. And the exact example shows how much you're doing.
Yeah.
I think Calen's seismic charge is just gonna reach that asteroid beside Thane and Dutch.
Ooh, that's.
I think it might just be in range.
That is a tough call. Oh man. I think you're right. I think it is just barely gonna reach, but we'll see when he actually has to measure for that.
It looks close.
Oh, it. Can't make that call. I would not bet on that.
No, hard to tell from our angle.
More coffee? Yeah, you bought two.
I doubled up.
I'll be back in a minute. I need more.
Such tight rebel flying going on here.
Yeah.
boosting up with Wedge, trying to get himself in for that shot. Probably not in this turn, but next turn he really wants to start feeding it. He made that rock. It was range one. Look at that. Slings out some bomb damage. Then there were five rocks.
They're not even set up yet.
No, probably not until like 11.
Yeah, it probably was
range one of all three of his ships, and
oh,
yep.
It really was
the seismic
you, eh?
Made it, yeah.
Oh, brutal.
That was a deadly claw on that seismic claw.
Oh.
Throwing that seismic out there.
Good, yeah. No, that is some good strat.
So he's got one damage on three different ships now.
Yeah.
And there hasn't even been a combat yet.
Nope, not yet.
No shots.
It looks like there's probably going to be some shots coming up
yeah,
next round.
Yeah, Wedge
here,
is coming in hard. He
oh,
wants to start
yeah.
firing those lasers.
Damn right, buddy. That's what Wedge is all about, is like blaster, blaster, blaster.
Fire my lasers.
I'm going to charge him my laser.
Taking some picks.
Yeah, buddy.
Oh. Take some picks before the chips start getting removed here.
Guys, I'll have to make sure you check out our social media for some of the pictures we're putting up of the other games. We have a lot of people who do their own custom painting on their ships. We have some beautifully repainted ships floating around here today. Black decimator that's got red tinting on it, red accent. That's a nice one. Damage out there. Whoops, no, not one of those. One for Dutch. One for Thane. And one off a Wedge. And I think he wants to go for that death range. What else do I need to remember here? Forgot.
forgot, I'm the one sitting in front of the con here. I got to update the damage and the...
Oh, yeah, yeah, dang. Yeah, because it's usually me.
Yeah.
Well, you can... You have, technically have
so you got
to,
it all up to date now?
Object,
yeah.
You have to pick.
You can also pick one of your own ships.
Yeah,
it's
that's
a, it's basically a useless lock, but...
You can't do just intentionally say, I failed the action to get the benefits of the...
Say, composure, for example.
Yeah.
There you go.
Do I get wedges locked in the mantis too? That's what happened. It means nothing. It's having locked up. That's why I do.
Yeah, it's. I like that it's really difficult to fail a target lock action.
I have.
You can
I
use,
have with Redline at the start of the game.
You like reach out and you're like, there's nothing. Damn it.
Yeah, because I was deployed here and everyone else is over here and there's no rocking range. It's like,
oh,
I
no.
actually fail a target.
But really, the whole point of doing that early is to measure to see
you,
how far things
you
go.
You set out at that point with the intention of purposely failing.
Had to clarify an arc for somebody. Wes is thinking really hard about his target priorityng here.
He doesn't want to get caught in a pincer.
Well, nobody
but
does.
But he also wants to get that death rain. So it looks like he's trying to bring his ships around.
It looks like he's heading for death rain then, eh? I don't know.
That would have been a great opportunity for a Talon.
Maybe.
With Thane. Well, it would have.
Yeah, perhaps. Yeah. It's hard to call. It depends on what his strat is going forward.
Yes. He also closed his S-foils on Thane.
Oh, that does make a difference to things. So you can't tell because he's using old-style X-Wings, so. I really need to get a bunch of those S-foil tokens to give out at tournaments for folks using old-style X-Wings.
Yeah.
Ooh. Tight to the rock there. Tight to the rock.
Take your target lock, and as long as the lock is successful, you just immediately say, and I link it into...
You don't have to.
It's a choice. No, linking is a choice.
So I'll do, from the free boost, I will check the target locks. We get a free lock. I'll put one of them on wood.
He must have started with them closed. I probably had that backwards. He's opened his S-foils.
Okay. Yes, I really...
Did you start with them closed? I had that backwards. My bad. Yeah.
Yeah, I really need to start handing out those S-foil tokens for folks with old-style X-Wings.
I think it's better to have this. So why do we X-Wing?
Yeah, one of mine is just, it's so stiff, I don't even bother trying. I just move my gear up, come on. So no Vader from Calen. So now we are into the actual engagement phase. Okay, so it looks like Dutch is gonna start things off for us.
Dutch is swarming up to B6. So Dutch is firing at 6 with Wedge.
Swarm tactics. Nice.
So he's firing 6.
And it looks like we got...
He's gotta make a decision.
He's thinking.
I think it's a safe bet. He's just being late.
I'm not gonna argue with you on that. I would too. So that's one into red line.
One on red line.
Oh, a little bit of cheat early, cheat often there.
Geektech staple.
You betcha. Well, like we keep saying, if you're not cheating on turn zero, you're not trying hard enough. Nice. Natties.
How much was that? Two?
Two and a crit, so on red line, 1-2, and damage sensor array.
Damage sensor array, rough.
Ouch. I like how Calen pantomimed rolling no dice. That was my favorite.
And nothing.
Oh, taking the shot at Whisper there, because that's the only shot he's got left with Thane there, I think, eh? Oh, and he's thinking, he's got two focuses. He's thinking
hard
about that now.
Thane and Wedge are both currently target locked by Redline.
Yeah.
Who hasn't fired yet.
I know, so it's...
Does he sacrifice the turtle and open one of his targets up?
Now, the biggest thing, that seismic has reduced everybody's...
He saved it.
If...
He still has to weather those shots.
If you have the choice... Spending your focus on attack or using it to weather your defense, always choose to weather your defense. Do not spend your token unless you
it's
need
a
to do it.
Shot.
Unless you're going to guarantee that shot through. Don't do it. It's a trap.
It's a trap. Whether you want to spend it. So he juked on Wedge.
Oh yeah. And he's thinking hard now. He's gonna spend it. He's not gonna spend it.
He's gonna
burn that shield.
Soak that last shield. He still has that proton.
He does. I can understand why he did that. Still, this proton could top deck lethal if he's not careful.
That's why he kept that focus.
And, Nelly.
A hit.
Crit hit. And Wedge is going to blank it out. Ow, straight to the hull. First crit. Not dead yet.
Wounded pilot and a loose stabilizer.
Yeah. I've murdered my Fen Rao with that accidentally before, so.
I hate the new stabilizer because every time I got it, because I'm one hit point left, I played someone who had it on Vader. So I was like, well, you have a one hit point crit with three stabilizers. You're either going straight or dead.
Yeah.
And I just went until he's right where he has to go straight. Like, what?
It's like, I know where you're going.
Got a concert happening next door to us, right through the wall that we're sitting beside. So you guys might hear some bleed through music.
But you know what? It ain't bad either.
No.
Just hope it doesn't get us flagged for copyright. I'm a little burned about that because, like, early on in our streaming career, Everything we made got burned for freaking copyright because we were always playing at Zealot's place.
And there was background.
And his wife was always on watching TV, and we were always getting the background, like, music from ads and shit was getting us flagged for copyright. Stupid, stupid stuff. So yeah, I'm a little bitter about YouTube's copyright.
Especially when it's from ads.
System.
Everything seems to be going well around here.
So next year,
you need
this
to
is a thing. I might try to set up something for, like,
projector.
On the big screen projector next year. I'll be right back.
She told us we could use it if we had stuff to project, like when we were setting up yesterday.
She's going to check the connector.
Yeah.
I would assume VGA.
I don't think I have a VGA out on here. I'd have to convert. That's not that hard, though.
I'm pretty sure I have an adapter.
Well, if we can get HDMI, DVI, VGA adapter.
Yeah. Yeah, we figured it out.
Next
we got
year.
An entire year.
Next year.
Entire year. A week from the
next one, we're going to be sitting there going, oh.
We're forgetting something. What were we talking about last year?
I don't know what you're talking about. That's never the way we operate every time.
Dropping that seismic. Try to get a little bit of extra action economy here.
Now.
Oh, yeah, I'm back again. Nobody's dead yet, eh?
Nope. We're just doing the next round of maneuvers.
This is a hell of a game.
Just the next round of maneuvers.
Oh, I know, but
well,
still,
I mean, Wedge is ready to pop. The poor guy. He's at one health. Loose stabilizer. Wounded pilot. So even if he does make a straight action, or a straight maneuver, take an action to turn his stabilizer down, it's going to stress him. It's going to stress him because of wounded pilot.
Yep. Yeah, because any action besides...
Any action.
Or any action is
will cause you a stress. Yeah. Technically, it's before you flip your dial.
For which?
S-foils.
Yes. Yeah, it's... Technically, it's before you reveal.
Kalen's being a gentleman about it, but he's explaining.
Kalen's almost always a gentleman.
He is a gentleman.
I'd rather you not get in the future. On something so technically, like, in.
Yeah.
It's one of the things, like, ailerons or strikers has to be done before reveal.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
You must. Why you do ship ability materials.
Yeah.
That Zeta right there.
Yeah, except I can't get that yet.
I know, you need to focus. I'm telling you, just focus on them pilots. Dark side pilots. Anyone who's a pilot on the dark side.
Trust me, I'm grinding them.
I know, it's hard. It took me forever. I feel your pain.
No, the problem I have is I don't have the executrix at the right fucking level.
You have to work on all the things. That's what I know. That's why I say you have to work on dark side pilots to unlock the executrix to the 5-star level. I get it. I've been there.
I have 5 of 5 ships. They don't meet that level yet.
Well, you actually, one of those five is it's kind of bugged. It's showing your capital ship as being one of those five. You need one more dark side ship that is appropriate.
Ugh.
Yeah, it shouldn't count your capital ship in that tally. It needs 5 ships that are that level other than. First order TIE fighter is astounding.
Yeah, I know.
Classic TIE fighter is astounding. TIE silencer, which farms right alongside of its pilot. Awesome, awesome farmable mode.
Oh, we're getting some little bit of shotgun bullying going on here.
Vader just killed Wedge.
Oh. Whisper. Whisper just. So that was Wedge?
Yeah.
Pop.
I believe that's how it works, right? So Packers took his first mate and activated initiative 6, and I killed then Wedge.
Yes. Yeah, so he'd still get the initiative buff, and then Wedge would go, goodbye!
Who's player one?
Then yes.
Then yeah.
Here comes another torp.
Ooh, natural forehead.
Natties for the win. Shield, hit crit. Crit is... What is it?
What is it?
Panic pilot, freezing
t-shirt. Stress, 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 and then it flips.
We'll fire range 2 from
crit on Dutch, so that's a shield and a crit on his hull. Ouch! Tokens is to buy ships so that you can get to the point where you can earn them for free.
I almost never reached the threshold to buy that Zeta. So
had to do it.
Hell yeah.
Have you Zeta'd anybody yet?
Ventress. Her leader ability.
Keep it up, buddy. God, I hope they give her a ship.
She has a ship.
I mean, in the game.
I know. It's coming.
I hope they give it.
It's coming. It's got to be coming. Fucking better be coming.
Did you take any hits there, Caitlin?
Whisper's taking
two shields.
Other than that, Red definitely not suffering
enough. Oh, I missed that. Shields are down on Whisper.
Ooh. Yeah. Makes sense.
And to recloak.
I probably would have hit him by accident, but I'm not going to get that. I've sent four hulls.
Yeah.
Yeah, the hull upgrade gives you the ability to be like, yeah, I'll soak that. Yep. Yeah, I guess it puts you sort of equivalent hit points with the X-Wings, eh?
Yeah.
They made the Phantom so much cheaper, too. They used to be such an expensive ship. They're still pretty expensive by the time you kit them out.
But this Whisper is 80 points, and Super Whisper is 45, so it's 90 points.
Yeah.
So it's on par with Super Whisper.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, but now you can crush the Vader on your Phantom and not kill yourself.
Yeah, that's the nice thing. It's not the suicide Phantom anymore.
Yeah.
Bounced to 518.
That's okay. You just need to be under the 5 before.
You know. I don't know why somebody would double Zeta a 3-star.
Distilla?
No. She's 3 stars.
Get that effect out there.
It's not going to matter. I'm going to rip the shit out of these guys.
Everything is up to date, except I forgot about Calen spent his other seismic charge here.
So both seismic are done? Okay.
There you go.
Thank you, sir.
Hello.
Yep. All right, Bally stepped away for a little bit. Still me rocking it here, guys. Just under half an hour left in this first round. So no bomb throw, but we do have the decloak from Whisper. Mm-hmm. right, Wes is bringing his shuttle around. Not an action. It's just something you can do during the system phase. Damage that last round? Or?
Well,
I don't know, I just want to. AP5 still fresh?
AP5 still fresh. Dutch just landed a rock, rolled a hand, got booted pilot because of major hull breach.
Hull breach. And Owen has wounded pilot now from that.
Yeah.
Ow, Dutch.
Yeah, it's not very nice. It's not the feature.
That's the only damage so far, Owen?
If you have a reinforced weapon, you have to spend it to.
No.
To
No, it just reduces down to a minimum of one. It can't reduce to zero. That's lethal, isn't it? Poor Dutch. Thane, buddy, it's all on you. Clean it up. There you go. Swaps out for his cloak. Thank you. Death Rain? Yeah.
He's the only one with the bombs.
Red Besides the charge back on Dread. Oh, yeah, that's right. Red Line's all about those torps. Has Red Line shot one? Both? Okay. There we go. Finally caught that up. Did Red Line turn down damage sensor array too, right?
Yeah.
Panic pilot's gone because that flips as soon as you receive the stress. Kalen's done quite well maintaining his margin. Looks appropriate to me.
Looks like poor Scott's about to get tabled. Or not tabled, but taken out.
You know what? That freaking quad swarm is a menace.
He's blanking out on torpedo rolls.
He has his dice.
Quad jumpers are just eating him alive.
Yeah, his dice were not great. His dice were not great.
Go pop a battle parade and get your dead. You hit him.
Oh, well, I can, right? X-Wing, 20 minutes. Range. No shots going on, it looks like. Carrying on here. Thane has a hell of an uphill battle going on. So we got a bomb fling in here, just to get the barrel roll from the look of it. Well, he reloaded both the seismic charges from the look of it. No, he didn't. Oh, yes, he did. So that was only, he still got one left. Thane is in a hell of a position right now. Yeah, right? Oh, what?
Go for that direct hit.
Right, yeah. Crit, direct hit. Never, nobody's ever said anything about painless, though. Yeah. Okay, here it comes.
So, I'll Vader choke you for one.
Oh, the Vader choke for one.
And then proton torque from red line.
Oh! Well, that was reloaded, and now he's spending it. And there you go. So, that's top deck lethal. And there it is, a 200 point win for Calen in the first round. Okay, well, that is round one here at Kippers Melee for the elimination rounds. We'll be back with round two in just a little bit, so don't forget, like and subscribe, leave some comments in the comment section down below, and check out our Patreon, patreon.com/geektechindustries. And we'll see you guys next time here on the mat.